Manny Pacquiao was ready for his showdown with Joshua Clady, but in his training camp, he sparred with many great fighters, including Jose Benavidez, Jamie Kavanaugh, David Rodella, Sean Porter, Mike Dallas, and the most veteran of them all, Steve Forbes. I caught up with the boxing star to talk about his career.
Oh man, a couple years, man.
Best shape for.
I think he'll be noted in this fight for being super tough. That's what he'll be noted. I'll be saying what shots he's taking, because I just see Manny just overwhelming him, man, with activity, speed, punching power, precision.
You sparred with him?
Yeah.
What's that like, to spar with him?
Oh, it's great, man. And you know what? He is a lot better technical than people give him credit for, man. I mean, he's been demolishing guys, so you don't, it's hard to gauge. You just see, oh, he's a brawler, but he's not, man. He's a technician, a good skilled technician, and he's getting better each time out.
What can you tell me about Steve Forbes, the boxing superstar?
Steve Forbes is in great shape right now, and that 140, he can beat any of those guys. Any of the guys that 140, I believe Steve can beat those guys.
What's that all about? Tiempo calendario.
Sí, yo lo
puedo. Oh, that's it.
Your weight class right now is the highest weight class out there.
Yeah.
You have Amir Khan, you have Victor Ortiz,
yeah.
You have Somia, Maidana.
Yeah.
What is it going to take for you to become the best pound for pound?
Working hard, man, and staying busy, staying in the gym. That's the key.
It's gonna happen, you?
It's gonna happen, definitely.
Any message to your fans?
Keep watching Steve Forbes, man, and you'll see the Forbes and Beard and Roach Connection.
Hey, I love your magazine, the Forbes magazine.
Yeah, that's it, man.
Hey, Forbes magazine just did a thing, 10 worst cities in America. You know what's number one?
Detroit, right?
Cleveland.
Oh, is it? Oh,
Sacramento was like top 10.
Wow.
No, I live in Cleveland. Live in Cleveland.
So good, all right, man, good luck.
All right, thank you, man.
Hey, Manny Pacquiao, Joshua Clady, how many rounds?
8 or 9 at the most, I think.
Okay.
I see Pacquiao overwhelming him with activity, and he places his shots good, so, you know, I think Clady's a tough guy, but I just seen him being overwhelmed. Too many punches, too many angles, too much speed, and too, you know, placement of punches, so.
What's it like to be a boxing sensation?
Oh, not yet, but to be working and coming here, man, is great. Freddie Roach is a great, great trainer, man, and a great person too, man. So.
No, but you're known in the world.
Yeah.
Millions of boxers out there.
Yeah.
Everybody knows your name. How does that make you feel?
Feels good, man. You know, every little kid just wants to be known. So I'm still want to be better. So, you know, I'm taking that approach to just want, and being a down-to-earth guy, man, you know. I love the fans, and you know, people in boxing are so great, man. So it feels good, man.
Let me ask, when you were a kid, who the one boxer you looked up to?
Oh, I loved, of course, I loved Sugar Ray Leonard, Muhammad Ali, Marvin Hagler was one of my favorites.
Many times fighters, when they have 1, 2, 3 losses, they get discouraged.
Right.
What kept you going?
Well, you know, because I would say the only two guys that beat me where I said they won the fight were Oscar De La Hoya and Andre Berto. And those fights were out of my weight class. So I think having the confidence to know that the losses that were there were somewhat controversial, you know, and highly noted controversial. So, and just believing in yourself and going back and saying, you know what, I'm going to change my game plan up. I'm going to get better. I'm going to keep learning. So that's it.
Berto's up-and-coming star, he's a champion.
Yeah.
De La Hoya is a legend.
Yeah.
What's it like to be stuck in between?
Hey, man, it's a great feeling. At the same time, you want to make your own mark, and by me coming back down to 140 pounds, I think I will.
Boxers, people don't know your name, they know your face. Who do they always confuse you with?
You know, it's hard, man. I don't know. They used to say Steve Johnson.
Akon.
Oh yeah, Akon.
They think you're Akon? Who do you have in the Floyd Mayweather Sugar Shane Mosley fight?
You know, it's hard. You got a favorite Floyd, but I think Shane, man, it's kind of like Shane's like a stalker almost. He's been wanting that big fight, and I think we're basically the best chain ever, man. I mean, it's a lot of venom between those two guys, and you know, we're just hoping for a great fight. I think it's gonna be a great fight.
Boxing star Steve Forbes in Los Angeles. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.